Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Mary. In this video, I'm going to review the Lotus Matte Gel Sunscreen in SPF 50. They have a lot of different variants with different SPF, like SPF 30, 40, 50, 70, and even 100. So let's begin with the review. Let's talk about the price and the quantity. For 100 grams of product of the 50 SPF, it costs 440 rupees. And for the price of other variants, you can check out the link in the description. Let's talk about the texture of this product. It looks like this. It is a little bit thicker than compared to like proper gel. Once you rub it in, it gets absorbed in a minute or two. And it does give a matte finish. Talking about the availability, it is available on Amazon, Flipkart, all major shopping websites and all other offline stores as well, because this is one of the most popular sunscreens that is available in India. Packaging is the same tube packaging with a flip top cap. Once you receive the product, cap is sealed properly with a plastic film. So that is it about the packaging. Let's move to the demo section. There's nothing great about it. It's just a simple way of applying sunscreen. I take a little bit of quantity, almost little bit more than a pea size, and apply it evenly all over the face and the neck, and that is how I apply it. Let's talk about the ingredients of this product. Now, I want to mention that few years back, they had a few different ingredients in the list. So they have definitely changed some of the ingredients as compared to what it was before. So this is the complete list of ingredients on the screen. However, I am going to break it down one by one, talking about what exactly it does. So let's talk about the first ingredient. First ingredient is DM water, which is demineralized water, which means a purified form of water. Now they have a lot of this long names of ingredients, so I'm not going to read each and every one of them. Next ingredient is a broad spectrum UV radiation absorber. It's a sunscreen ingredient. It is broad spectrum, which means it gives protection from UVA as well as UVB rays. The third ingredient is another similar UV rays absorbing ingredient. Fourth one is commonly known as avobenzone, but they have mostly used all those longer names. This was very commonly used in most of the chemical sunscreens, and it's a good safe ingredient. Fifth one is another UV absorber. Sixth one is another chemical sunscreen ingredient. There are a lot of these UV absorbers in the first few ingredients, which is a very good thing. Seventh one is horsenut extract, and after this there are few plant extracts that are used. Eighth is vanilla extract. Ninth is comfrey extract. Tenth is a thickening agent. Next is a silicone. Now silicone it acts as a skin conditioning agent. Then after this is another silicone as well, which acts as an emulsifying agent. Next is a fragrance ingredient. It has a very strong noticeable fragrance in it. So the fragrance ingredient is an irritant, and it is not something that I would want or recommend in any skincare product. So the 14th ingredient is a preservative. It can also be sensitizing. 15th one is phenoxyethanol, which is commonly used in a lot of skincare products as a preservative, which is usually safe enough. 16th one is like an absorbent. 17th is a fragrance ingredient again. The last two ingredients are parabens. Parabens are also used as a preservative in a lot of creams and leave-on skincare products. These were all of the ingredients that is there in this particular sunscreen. Okay, so that is all from the ingredients side of things. Now talking about what is my overall thoughts about it. So this is not a new product for me. I've been using it for many years, and it did not irritate my skin when I was using it. When I started reading more about ingredients, that is when I stopped using it, and then I was in search of a good sunscreen. In spite of being a gel-based formulation, it is still very thick. Maybe they should have skipped silicones and fragrance because of this. It feels heavy on the skin in spite of it being a gel-based formula. It does cause sweating, and because of this heavy feel, it won't feel great underneath makeup. Looking at all the ingredients that are placed, there are few sensitizing ingredients which they should have changed as well. When they changed some of the ingredients, they should have at least removed some of the silicones. Silicones are not usually bad, but it just becomes like a heavy layer on top of the skin, especially for oily skin. It becomes like causes excess sweating, so that is not something I would like in a skincare product. With makeup, it's fine. There's fragrance as well in it, and because of these few ingredients, it's not something that I would want to continue using, and not something I would recommend, because many years back there was very few options in terms of sunscreens. But now there are a lot of options, there are a lot of sunscreens available which are fragrance free, so that is why I wouldn't want to recommend this. So that is it from this video. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the thumbs up button. Make sure you are subscribed to my channel for more such review videos for skincare tips and makeup related videos as well, and you can find a lot of these videos from the description box down below. And yeah, that's it. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.